Canada in the gold medal game for the 10th consecutive year. The Russians in it for the first time since 2007 when they lost to Canada in Leksand, Sweden. And in front of a capacity, largely Canadian crowd, we are underway. He fights off Barrison, taps it back for Ellis. And Ryan Ellis walks in, lays it down for Shen, for DeHaan. Now Shen with time, walks in, Shen plays it across, Ellis shoots it!
Play is lethal because of the size of Zach Cassian, the willingness of Brian Johansson to go to the front of the net, and then the puck distribution skills of guys like Calvin DeHaan, Braden Shen, and then the finishing ability of Ryan Ellis. And that's just a hammer time by Ryan Ellis, but what a pass by Braden Shen. Two big bodies in the slot. There's no way that Dmitry Sheikin can get across the crease that quickly as he tracks the puck. Ryan Ellis gives Canada a 1-0 lead.
Here's Cassian now, breaking away with Johansson. The chip play ahead to Ryan Johansson. Works his way back in front. Cassian backhand shot. Pad save by Sheikin. 5:17 to go. The score clock at center ice. Working intermittently to hear the crowd pulling that. Now Kuznetsov works in. Evgeny Kuznetsov. Play by Barry. Tyson Barry reached in, got the puck and took it away. And Pivzaka with a shot that goes just wide. LeBlanc sent flying by Zaitsev. Ashton works for the puck. Picks it up in the corner. Plays it down for LeBlanc. Back for Ashton. Carter Ashton. Oh, shit!
At some point, all the board pressure against the Russian defenseman is going to take its toll. And as we go along at the trail end of the first period, you can see the physical play by Canada, protecting the puck hard on it. There's a fatigue play for Golubev. He can't stay with Carter Ashton. Louis LeBlanc, he wears them out. No rotation. Had a short side by Carter Ashton. Great shot. The first round pick of the Tampa Bay Lightning, a former Regina Pat, off the bar and in.
Canada has not yet been shorthanded in this game. Foligno sends it in front.
It's the forecheck pressure that won't go away. Braden Shen hard on it. Get a little support. Cody Eakin get more support. Foligno over to Shen to the back of the net and in a hurry. That's just great two-man pressure, and Braden Shen, left-hand shot on the right-hand side of the ice. He's not going to even try to stop that puck. He doesn't get great wood on it, but he gets enough on it to make it 3-0 Canada. Goaltending change.
We've got a goalie change for the Russians. Sheikin goes off after allowing three goals on 18 shots. So on comes Igor Bobkov of the London Knights. Ellis sends it deep to Johansson. Ryan Johansson feeds it back to Ellis. Chance in front. Ellis back with it. Tarasenko. He's got Subchenko streaking ahead. Here comes Subchenko. Short-handed in. Stop by Byzantine. Walking in is Golubev. For Panarin. Traffic in front. Shot by Barrison off the inboards to Golubev. Loose in front. Tarasenko back out. They score. Panarin. And Artemi Panarin gets the Russians back in it 2.5 minutes into the third period.
Canada can't keep sitting back, and the Russians are going to prey on that all the time. It's a great job of gaining the line, working on Tyson Barry. Enough bodies are back in red. Puck comes through the lively boards. We've seen them before. Out in front to Panarin, and he just snaps it right by Mark Byzantine. But those lively boards keep the puck alive. Tarasenko back on the ice for the Russians, and a finish by Artemi Panarin to make a 3-1 Canada.
And the KHL, which is the last place team in that league, and not by a little. Now Kuznetsov comes in. Kuznetsov feeds it in front. Save Byzantine. Kitson. And it's 3-2 Canada.
Just sitting back isn't the tonic for Canada. And right off the faceoff, you can see that they took the play right to Dylan Olsen. Watch number four. They go right at Dylan Olsen. They're not going to back off, so they back Dylan Olsen off. Drive to the net. More bodies there in white than red because everybody's stuck in the neutral zone, and they ran out of racetrack too quickly. It's a great job by Kuznetsov working on Dylan Olsen right out front and Maxime Kitson. The chemistry between Kuznetsov and Kitson has been great all tournament long, and it's great right there to make it 3-2.
Goals 11 seconds apart have the Russians right back in it. Tarasenko down low to Kuznetsov. Still with it, spins, feeds it in front, score! Tarasenko ties it up!
That's a special goal by world-class players. Tarasenko was hurt at the end of the second period. Most people thought he wasn't going to come back. And you see the passion level that the Russians have had all tournament long. They've been down by three in this game, but they want the puck. Tarasenko keeps alive. Kuznetsov strong on the boards against Ryan Johansson. And everybody focuses in on Kuznetsov and not the back door of Tarasenko. And you can see the stick of Jared Cowan after the goal goes in. He slams it on the ice. Canada's now calling a timeout.
Savchenko with the Berechanski and Kuznetsov. In comes Kuznetsov with a shot and Byzantine the glove save. Back goes Gudbranson. Five to go in a tie third period. Tarasenko feeds it up. There, loose in front. Stopped by Byzantine with a save. Golubev feeds it across. Orlov with a shot that was blocked by Howden. Cizikas to Howden. Tried to hack it ahead. Here they come again. Tarasenko. Keeps it in front, they score! Panarin gives the Russians the lead with 4:38 to go.
Well, now you can't sit back if you're Canada. A tough sequence for Eric Gudbranson. Deep in his own zone, he turns the puck over, and then the Russians engage the forecheck. Here's the tough turnover, he just overskates the puck. Good pressure by Tarasenko. They can't get good wood on it. Panarin tries, the Russians keep it alive. Getting it in deep, fan shot. Quinton Howden just can't control this puck. When Casey Cizikas gets it to him, it gets stripped off the stick. And then they just play give and go, and not enough bodies back.
Josh Gratton and the like. But a big goal here, and Cowan hammers that wide. So Canada trailing again. Perry with a shot, loose in front, ball caught down. The puck's under him, and Cassian can't get to it. And Sergeyev finds Kalinin 2-on-1 with Kuznetsov. In comes Kalinin, feeds it across, Kuznetsov puts it wide in a wide-open net. Two and a half to go.
You're going to see more of that because Canada's got to gamble with their defensemen and jump them up.
Now firing around, Barry races to it, can't get there. And Dvorchinski's in. In comes Dvorchinski, he scores! Nikita Dvorchinski. Five unanswered goals for the Russians, and they lead it 5-3.
That's just an amazing offensive explosion by the Russians. These guys have been through it all tournament long, starting in the quarterfinals, coming from behind against the Finns, in the semifinal against the Swedes, and against Canada in the final. Finishing off, Dvorchinski wins a foot race against Tyson Barry and right through the five hole on Mark Byzantine to make it 5-3 Russia.
The Russians have called timeout, back from 3-0 down in the third.
This is the greatest collapse in the history of the World Junior.
The draw won, and the Russians are back. World Junior champions for the first time since 2003.
Победа, Россия!
For the second straight year, Canada is beaten in the gold medal game in what you would have to say is stunning fashion. But this one might be even harder to take than that one. Ryan Ellis won't even wear his.
It's a bitter pill. It's a really tough thing. He loses in overtime on a great shot by John Carlson last year. And this year with a 3-0 lead going into the third period, they kill off the first 46 seconds of a penalty. And then all of a sudden they just start sitting back and they never get their game plan back engaged. They give up 5 goals in the third. We've never seen a collapse like that in the World Junior in a gold medal game. Not even Helsinki, where Canada had a 3-1 lead. It was like this. He's almost ready.
And Orlov won't be far behind, probably.
Well, he's paddled that trip like Kuznetsov, and Orlov is a lot like Sergei Zubov, maybe with a harder shot. It's a great story. You have to give the Russians a ton of credit. Down 3-0 on foreign soil. Everybody cheering against you. Life and death to beat the Finns. Life and death to beat the Swedes. You're down with 20 miles to run, and you come back and pop 5 on the best team in the tournament. That's an amazing accomplishment.
The Swedes set the Russians a note. Congratulations, Canada. Congratulations, Russia, from Team Sweden. Congrats, Russia. World champs. And here it is. Rene Fizel presents the World Championship trophy to the Russians. Tarasenko directing traffic, and there you go. And they'll skate it right by the Canadians.
There'll be some guys remembering that next year.
Well, only one of these Russians can come back.